Dani, junk bonds have been the centre of our focus for the last week or so, but it isn't just debt investors. Equity peers are doing it too, which this chart perfectly illustrates,
right? And if you look at this chart here, it's been happening far before we had this junk bond sell-off. You know, I feel like there's this idea that bond investors, they're the smart guys, right? They're the pessimistic ones. They know when there's trouble brewing. But if you had been paying attention to equities, and this is U.S. equities, this is globally, this is in Europe. In fact, if you separate them by companies with strongest balance sheets versus the weakest, investors have really been shunning companies that have built up a lot of net debt. We're in late stages of the cycle. There's some idea that central banks are going to tighten monetary policy, and people are getting nervous that these companies aren't going to be able to continue to create shareholder value.
So this has been happening for a while, but right now, Stuart, whether it's junk bonds or commodities, everything seems to be coming to a head. Why in the commodity space?
I think it's just too fast. And if you look at the length on the speculative side, I mean, they were at record lengths, certainly in the oil complex. You look what's happening in the base complex. Again, much the same thing. Everyone had gone far too long. And, you know, regardless of your view on whether China keeps expanding or not, and I think the consensus is it probably keeps expanding, but at a slower rate. Fundamentally, you can't have a 20-30% gain in a big commodity and not expect some sort of pullback. And I think that's really what we're seeing at the moment. It's not capitulation.